with your song. It's great for us. I wonder, that my question, could you hazard to reimagine what was the funeral like in this roofless abbey when Chibabana died?
Well, you know, they all went back to the old village. It was comforting, it was what they knew, what was the Reardon. And as I think I said in the talk, everything was politically expedient. If you did conform, you conformed for a while. It was like the old surrender and rebrand. Do you remember that from Henry VIII when he asked the Irish chieftains, you know, to accept an English title and agree to rule by the laws? And they said, well, thank you very much for the title. Once the army had disappeared over the hill, they were back to where they were. I think it would have been a very special day. I would imagine that thousands of people would have come here. He was the most influential man in Mayo at the time. I think this abbey would have been absolutely black with people who would have walked here, I'm sure, ridden on horseback, pony. I wouldn't say pony, a tramp in the 1600s, mostly would be walking carts, anyway they would come. And they would pay respects to their chieftain. You know, he was a chieftain, as I said at the beginning. He may not be emphasized to a degree, but it was just for political expediency. And I think when he died, he went back to his roots. And I would imagine that this candlelight, my goodness, you know, maybe it was raining like it was today. You know, and still that his family here, all the people they would have brought, they'd all become established in various castles. He left them various castles. So they would have brought all their followers, and it would have been an event, there is no doubt about it. And I think the abbey, if I may say so, is, you know, it's really a side of the abbey that hasn't been told. You know, we know about the abbey who has never died, but I've tried to bring the story of a guy who never gave in either, against the most awful odds. And I think the abbey's right that he should be in this abbey. More than likely, he had never got from McKevley, and his father had never been the man. He'd have been buried in Murashuna, which is here, and I think it's very special that he is here, and I'm sure that it would bring a lot of interest to the abbey, the fact that the Lord Mayo is here. Indeed, I often feel sorry that I didn't call the biography Lord Mayo. When I called it Shadow Lord, he was in the shadow of his mother, and he certainly was in the shadow of history, and that's why I choose that title. But I think on second thoughts, Lord Mayo would have been